another hour of meditating together. And just to say that I'm new to this. No, but also that meditation techniques, there are so many. But I find for myself, I just have to invent what works for me. So we learn techniques and we learn what works for other people. And I'm just sharing things that I've, for myself, I've created really, that work for me. But really it's about experimenting and taking some of the principles that we hear of over and over and again. And finding your own way of bringing those principles to life. And a technique is just something that has worked for somebody. So I encourage you, just as I have done, to just be very imaginative. Allow yourself to not necessarily have to stick to the right way. And come up with what works for you in looking at how, when you try a particular way, what does your heart feel after that? How do you feel more? Do you feel more, less ego, less clinging, less sense of me, solidity? So if whatever it is your technique that you are doing leads to these experiences, then try it again. It might not work the next time. In fact, it probably won't. So yeah, saying all of that, there was a request for metta meditation. So I will do it the way it works for me. And maybe it works for you. But again, like I said there, this is just after years of suffering. you go, aha, I think I found something. So unless you're a gifted meditator, which there are in the world, you would probably have to go down the same path. So, so we can start by just closing our eyes. And just bringing your mind again to being in this room, in your body, on your cushion. Your mind to quieten down be at ease, to know that you are safe. Know that you have nothing to do for the next hour, nothing special to achieve. Allowing things to just unfold. When you are ready, perhaps bring to mind someone or something who in your mind embodies unconditional love. Who you, when you are in their presence, if you have met such a person, or it could be your dog, that when you are in your in their presence, you don't feel judged. You feel you can be yourself. Someone who does not expect anything, who is themselves regardless of how you are. So, this could be for me, a spiritual teacher, it could be the Buddha, it could be a tree. It could be your dog. Imagine or remember what it feels like. To not be judged. To have someone who is just there. What does it feel like? To receive, to be in the presence of. yourself to disappear. And all you feel is the presence, being in the presence. The mind drifts away, bringing it back to that sense of you're not really being that person, being yourself, but you are part of that other person. Yourself. After a while, you start to feel, at least imagine what it may be like to be that person who cares unconditionally. Something in you recognizes it. Something in you recognizes that same quality that is in you is also in this extraordinary person. Ability to love unconditionally. starts to drift away. Imagine again the presence of this person. Sometimes it helps to fill in the colors, fill in the experience, that memory with sounds and emotions and coloring up the picture so that you remember it more fully. But in the end, what we want is an emotion, a feeling. Whatever that means for you. So, being in the presence of this being, you also know a little bit, somehow, what it means to be them, to be in their shoes. Something in you gets it. And so, being in their shoes, imagine seeing through their eyes and seeing the people around you. Seeing the people that are close to you. Around you. Nobody in particular, but just that sense of seeing through their eyes. And knowing what it means to love unconditionally. having this sense in your mind. Keep it in your heart and allow it to grow. In whatever way helps you. Allowing it to permeate yourself. And exude out into the world. So I leave you for the next half an hour to experiment. See if this helps you to understand what true love is. If your mind drifts away, you can find it useful to direct this loving kindness towards particular individuals or just a sense of exuding that feeling. bringing your mind back. Back to the beauty. Being unconditional love itself. That is taught in the suttas is to direct the sense in the four directions, above, below, around and everywhere. Remembering there are beings that we don't see as well. Beings in different states of existence. Sun goes out to all beings. Nameless, faceless beings. before we finish. Perhaps you can try to bring that sense of love to someone that may be a bit difficult in your life. You see that person through the eyes of unconditional love. To see that that person doesn't really know what they're doing. From a great being's point of view, none of us really know what we're doing. We are just bundles of habit. Unenlightened worldlings. Not knowing what is really wholesome and unwholesome. So through the eyes of someone who sees far greater, all you can do is forgive. Because most of us don't really know what we're doing. We come to the end of the meditation and just spend a few minutes just recollecting where the mind has been in the last hour. And dedicating the merit of our practice to all beings. All beings everywhere. You're ready, you can open your eyes. See you again in 15 minutes.